So in the previous videos, we spent a lot of time talking about organizing our code. To really reap the benefits of our code organization, let's now talk about model logging, basically tracking the training progress. So why do we care about model logging actually? So one of the reasons is that we, of course, want to see how the training progresses. So we want to track the loss function, for example, during training. It will then, of course, also help us debug our model and, of course, also help us to improve our model. And, of course, it's always useful to keep records. So if we want to go back later, it's always useful to have these records so that we can make checks or other improvements. So when we talk about logging, what are some of these basic things we want to watch out for and capture? So one of the most important things that we want to capture when we are logging our model is the training loss. So in this plot, we are seeing the epochs on the x-axis and the loss on the y-axis. And yeah, what we want to see here is that the training loss is going downwards, which means that the model is making progress and is still learning. Then it's often also helpful to check whether our model is overfitting. So here again, we see the number of epochs on the x-axis and the accuracy on the y-axis. And we can see that the training accuracy goes upward, but at some point the validation performance stagnates. And then we see this gap between the training and the validation set performance, which is an indicator that this particular model is overfitting. So in this video, we are not going to discuss how we can fix this overfitting problem. This is a topic for a future lecture, but it's at least useful to know about it. And so here we can see with logging, we can capture this overfitting so that we can then later learn about techniques to address it. So along with the training loss and the model performance, it's of course also useful to capture the hyperparameters that correspond to the model. Because capturing the hyperparameters is crucial later on to associate the right loss curve with the right setting. So conveniently, the Lightning module can help us to capture these hyperparameters together with the log files. So in fact, it will capture everything we pass into the init method. For example here, the learning rate. However, in this case, we don't want to capture or save the model, which is quite large and not a hyperparameter, which is why we specifically ignore it when we call save hyperparameters here. So now that we talked about the benefits of logging, what are actually the different loggers that are available in Lightning? So in this slide, we see all the different loggers that are currently available. And by default, Lightning is using the open source Tensorboard Locker. So we use Tensorboard from the command line to show the results of the model training in the browser. And we can do that during training or after training. However, loggers are something that are usually best experienced live. So in the next video, we will actually apply the Tensorboard Locker to our Lightning training script and see how it looks like in action.